Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to explain and demonstrate about the flow control measurement system. By this system, students can learn the process of flow measurement by the different transducers and sensors and how the flow will operate and how we use the DAQ systems in the flow measurement and controlling in the industrial purposes. So we will go through with the different experiments. Now I will also explain you the all modules about these. So what we have used in this kit, and we will follow the procedure to see how process will be controlled of the flow. The water is the medium for this. You can understand the flow measurement through the water right now, but by this method students can easily understand on the other liquid and other mediums how the flow controlling will be work. So this is the complete setup of flow process control system. In this we are using the 6 different modules for different working, and there is a container and the whole system is situated on the process workbench, so it is easy to capable and handling. Now I will explain you all the modules one by one, then I will explain you all the 4 sensors that we are using, and also about the rotameter and also the flow process by the motor and the solenoid valves. So all will be explained one by one. Now I will explain starting with the single phase power supply module. In this, the input from the mains with this cable connected with the power socket for the any 220 volt source, and 220 volt input will be provided. As we own this MCB, the power socket will forward the supplies to all the panels, and this is the output from the 230 volt AC sources. So this will be connected with all the panels simultaneously, and there is a multifunction meter by which we can measure the and read the voltages, current and frequency. All the parameters of single phase supplies are provided here. So when we use the loadings, you can also observe the amperes loaded on this. There is a pilot lamp which indicates the single phase power supply is on. Now moving on, there is the digital control panel meter. In this, where we are using the PID controller. For this, we are providing the input 4 to 20 milliamps. So we will have to set the settings for the 4 to 20 milliamps in the flow control meter, and this will show the process flow on in the liters per minute by measurement of sensors. And these are the digital outputs, controlled output here, which provides the different outputs as requirements, and this is also can be communicated with the PC interface. Here there is a current meter which will calibrated as per the flow. So the sensor output in the analog output 4 to 20 milliamps will be provided with this current. So we will use both the meters one by one to see the different modules how the process control requires in this, how these meters and PID control and current meters are required. Now moving on, this is the input output panel for the DAQ panel. So these are the physical inputs provided: start, stop, pump and valve, and these are the inputs that can be operated from here. So the terminals are provided. This will be connected with the DAQ module. I will explain you the DAQ module later. Here also the indicator output connected. So these are the indicator outputs. This will show the status of the working. As we are working with the pump indicator will glow, and when we work with the valve, so the valve indicator will be glow, and there is alarm buzzer inside installed that when we stop the process, this will blow for the 15 seconds and then automatically stops. Also there are some relays connected inside to control the contactor for the pump and also the contactor for the solenoid valve to operating them. These are already connected properly, so you do not need to connect and verify whether which is the pumps connections and which are the valves connections. Now moving on, there is the DAQ panel. In this, the data acquisition and control will be happen, and DAQ module consists of 3 DIs, 4 DI digital inputs and 4 digital outputs that we have used in the different processes. Also there is this 4 analog inputs in which we will provide the analog outputs from the sensors. This will be read and measured and controlled as per the requirement. The whole programming will already done in the DIQ module. This DIQ module can also be configured with the PC interface with this socket, and this module is already interfaced with the HMI. The HMI programming already done as per the requirement and as per the flow system of this kit. And this is the AC supply socket which is forwarded from digital control panels to providing this, and also there is a DC supply. This is the distribution of DC supply of 24 volt DC. This will be provided forwarded from the for the to the HMI panel and also to the digital control panel to provide the different modules. And now we will move on to the HMI panel. So this is the 7 inches LCD TFT screen HMI provided here. This has a resistive touch and different color module. All the screens and programming parameters are already designed as per our flow control system. So we will see how the pressures and the input output from the HMI module also works by controlling the different modules from the HMI. And also we will measure the different data logs of the different values that we are using and at which we are working. And also we can see the graphs and the graphic and the visual representation of the system on the HMI also. So this will work on the 24 volt DC power supply that we have provided from the distribution panel of the DIQ panel. Now moving on, the last module is the sensor panel module, in which we have connected a turbine flow sensor and electromagnetic flow sensor. The AC supply is also provided from the distribution panels, and DC supply and AC supplies are connected as per the requirement. So these are the easy plug and go cables connected from the sensors. So these are already connected. You do not need to open and do the different connections. So we will just take out the output terminals from the sensors to as per our requirement. So we will follow the different procedures explained in the user manual as per the experiments and do the flow process control system study. So now I will explain you about the sensors and the turbine meters that we are using here. So this is the first flow sensor. This is the turbine flow sensor, and this works when the power, when the flow of water goes through this, and this will generate some electromagnetic values that will be useful for our sensor measurement. And similarly, there is a flow transmitter. This is the electromagnetic flow sensor. In this, as the flow of the water is provided, the conducting medium is the water right now that we are using. So we required a conductive medium flow for this sensor to work. So as the conductive medium flows from the sensor, there are two electrodes situated on the both sides. This will generate a power, and this will move the magnetic pickup, and this pickup will later transmit the values as per the electromagnetic inductions, Faraday's laws working. So the whole explanation of the sensor is also given in the user manual. You can easily study with this. So after the sensor give output in the current, we will measure this output from the turbine sensor panel and on the different DIQ and the PID controller setups also. So all the system with the proper pipe and valve arrangements are given. There are different valves situated, so we will also do the valve settings as per the requirement. So when we on the valve 1 and valve 3, the pressures will be only, and the flow of the water will only flow from the required sensors as per the valve arrangement. And there is also a rotor meter. This is the mechanical and the physical basic meter for measurement of flow in the LPMs. So this will also show the liters in the actual measurement, and we will also compare the actual and the flow from reading of the sensors. Now there is also a tank. This is the measurement tank here, in which the water pumped by the sump tank will be inserted, and we will measure the flow after the sump tank filled. And then we control, when we off the pump, the water will automatically drain through the solenoid valve installed here. So when we off the pump, the solenoid valve will be on, and this will return the whole water to the sump tank. And this is the basic sump tank or the storage tank to measure the flow of different waters. There are some different walls. So this is the inlet wall 1A. Here we can provide the water from this wall in the tank, the sump tank. And this is the wall 4. This will forward the water from the measurement tank to the sump tank. But for this we have to close the 1A wall. And there is also a wall 2A. This will return the pump sucked water or the flow. So when the pump is on and we want to return the whole pressure from inside the sump tank without flowing it to the measurement sections, so we will change the flow to the sensors by closing this wall. This is the wall 2A here, and this is the wall 5 here. This will provide the water to the sensors when we use the input measurements. And also there is a drain valve here. This is the drain valve 4A. This should be closed while working the experiment, and when you want to empty the tanks, all the tanks, you can open this valve. So all the waters from the sump tank and the measurement tanks will be take out. And moving on, there are two valves also at the upper end. So this is the valve 1. When we use the turbine flow sensor, the valve 1 will be open, and when we use the electromagnetic flow sensor, the valve 3 will be open, other valves will be off. And the third measurement is the rotameter. So when we use the rotameter, the valve 2 will be open and other two valves will be closed. So we will use one by one all the valves and all the sensors to measure the flows and to understand the study of flow process control system. So we will now do the experiments as per the user manual. We are also providing a user manual for flow measuring instrument and the flow process control system, in which the experiments and the whole study and setups are provided. So you can easily understand the flow process control system by understanding all the sensors and modules. So this is the whole setup of different sensors and measurements. Now I will explain you the first fixed connection wiring diagram. This is required to do all the experiments. So this is the fixed connection wiring diagram as per the setup. So I will explain you first. This is the visual diagram and this is the tabular flow. In this, the single phase power supply wiring, this is the panel, single phase power supply. By this wiring, the T1, T2 terminal of the single phase power supply is provided to the digital control meter panel T15, T16. So you can also observe this, that the single phase power supply panel T1 and T2 are provided to the T15 and T16 of the digital control panel meter. So these are the fixed wiring as per the tabular form. You can also understand all the fixed wiring as described in the user manual. So from which DAQ wiring, like DAQ wiring, digital control wiring, so all the wirings and connections are fixed. This will be remains constant for all the experiments. And this is the visual representation also given in the user manual. So these are the patch codes are also provided to do the experiments. Now we will move on to the PID controller setup, in which we have to do and control the settings as per the requirement. So our input should be 4 to 20 milliamps in the current meter and also in the PID controller. So the input types and the different types of input for the PID controller are also explained in this user manual. And this is the current meter settings. In this, we have to set all the settings as per the requirement. Now moving on to the first experiment. So aim to study the measurement of water flow using flow sensor and DAQ and HMI. So by completion on this experiment, we will understand the working of DAQ, digital acquisition control system, and human machine interface HMI, and its application for controlling flow processes. And description are also given. And this is the tabular diagram for the connections of DAQ wiring and sensor connections. And this is all the connections apart from the fixed connections are given in this visual diagram. So we will do the connections as per the experiment. So now we will do the connection as per the experiment. So we will first do the DAQ wiring for this input output panel, the input output panel, the T5, T6, T7 and T8, these are the digital inputs will be provided to the digital inputs of the DIQ panel. So we will do this wiring. So we will connect T5 with T11. This is the DI0, the digital input of the DIQ system. T6 with the T2. Similarly, the other two inputs for the pump and valve are connected to the DIQ system. So we will connect T7 and to T13 and T8, the valve input, to the DI3. Now we will connect the outputs status indications with the DIQ outputs. So the status of the output will be provided through the indicator lamp and alarms. So we will connect the digital outputs from the indicator output. So the T13 will be connected with the T19 of the DO0. This is the digital output that we are providing to the DIQ module. And the pump output from the DIQ module and the valve output from the DIQ module. So this will show the indications as per requirement. So these are the connections for the input output module. Now we will connect the sensor connections. For this, we will first use the turbine flow sensor and also the electromagnetic flow sensor. Both the connections will be done, and then we change the valve connections as per the requirement to do the study. So we will connect the T5, the turbine flow sensors, and sensor 1. This will be connected with the T23 of the DIQ panel. So this is the analog input, and T17, this is the electromagnetic sensors output, will be connected with the AI0 T15 of the DIQ module. So these are the complete connections that we have done here. Now we will follow the procedure to operate the valve, and all the valves abbreviations are also given in the user manual. So this is the basic flow process diagram provided here, and valves are also provided. So this is the V1A valve and V4, V2A, V3A, and solenoid valve is described as the SV, and this is the V5. This is the bypass valve for the measuring tank, and this is the V4A drain valve, and this is the pump indication are given here. All the lines are connected as per the requirement, and the abbreviation are also given, that the EF is for electromagnetic flow sensor, and FT is for flow turbine sensor, and TF is the turbine flow sensor, and RM is the rotor meter, and SV is the solenoid valve, and P is for the motor pump. All the valve numbers and different valve functions are provided, that the V1 is for turbine flow sensor inlet, V2 is the rotor meter inlet, V3 is the electromagnetic flow sensor inlet, V4 is the control of return flow water into the sump tank, and V5 is the manual outlet of the measuring tank. So we do not require to open the solenoid valve. We can open the V5 valve for outlet, and solenoid valves are also to outlet of the measuring tank, and V1A inlet of the sump tank to fill the water, V2A return flow control of the motor pump into the sump tank, and output flow control of the motor is the V3A pump into the flow sensor, and output V4A is the outlet of the sump tank for drainage. So these are the different valves explanation that went for all the valves, and this is the procedure to control the flow, and that we have connected all the connections. Now we will on the single phase power supply and see the flow. Before that, we will have to do the valve setup as per the flow. So we will keep the valve V1, V3A, V4 and V5 open, and V2, V3, V1A and V2A and V4A closed. So this setup has to be done for measurement of turbine flow sensor, sensor 1. So we will do this. For this, we will open the valve V1A, sorry, V1, and we will close the valve V3, so the water will be flow from only the maximum flow of the water will be from only the sensor 1, the turbine flow sensor. Also we need to close the valve V2, so V2 is already closed. And now going to the down sections, we will have to do the connections, sorry, the valve operations. So V3A and V4 and V5 should be open. So V4 is already open here and V5 is already open and V3A is also open. So these are the open valves, and also we need to close the V1A. So V1A is closed, V3 is should be closed, that we have already closed upper side, and V2A should be closed. So V2A is right now closed, and V4A also need to close. So this is the drain valve that have been also closed here. So now we will power on the supply and see the flow measurement through the DAQ and HMI. So we will on the power supply. Now we will on the power supply with this MCB, so you can see the input showing at the meter and also at the HMI. So HMI will take a few seconds to properly boot up, and this will boot in a few seconds and then will be observed. Right now we can observe the input supplies. This is the 243 volts input at the 50 hertz supply. Right now there is no load as we do not on the pump. When we on the pump, the loads of the pump will be shown at the ampere sections. Now you can see there is no flow at the flow sensor 1 that we are using here, flow sensor 1. So we will start. First press the start button to start the process. The indication of status is also showing at the input output module, and now we will start the pump by pressing and touching the pump button here. So as I press the pump, so now we will on the pump here. The pump has been on, and the flow from the turbine flow sensor is the maximum amount of the water will be flowing through the turbine flow sensor, and this is showing the output of flow sensor. This is about 39 liter per minute, and pump is on. So this is how the flow is measured by the flow sensor 1, and we can also change the flow by turning off the valve V2A slowly. So the flow will be changed as the flow will be divided in the two valves. So the direct output to the sump tank will be on, and the flow to the turbine flow sensor will be decreases. So you can see at the measuring tank the water is incoming in the tank right now from the pump, from the sump tank. And now I will slowly close down the valve V2A, and this will affect the water flow value. So as I close the water slightly, about 25%, you can see on the measurement section the flow has been decreased from about 1 liter here, as the HMI showing. Now I will close the valve some more, and you can observe the flow will be decreased. So now I have closed the valve about 50%. So you can observe the flow is also decreased. The measurement of the flow is decreased. The flow is decreased from the turbine flow sensor. So flow is right now 25 liter per minute as I have turned the valve closed. And if I close the valve fully 100%, then the flow will be completely goes off from the flow sensor. Now I will open this valve completely, so the flow will directly in the sump tank from the pump, and flow measurement is approximately zero measured by the flow sensor. So here you can see the flow is very light here, and if I close the valve of the flow sensor also, so this will show the complete output will be zero. So that I have closed the inlet of the valve, so there is no water present inside, so the flow will be completely zero. So this is how we control the flow sensors, that we have measured the flow first from the turbine flow sensor. Now we will do the same experiment for the electromagnetic flow sensor or the flow transmitter. So now after the measurement, we can stop the process by pressing the, first we change the process to the valve. As I touch the valve button here, so pump will be off and the solenoid valve is right now on. This will take out the water of the measurement tank through the solenoid valve to the sump tank, and this process can also be visualized on the HMI also by pressing this icon. So you can see the water is flowing from measuring tank by solenoid valve to the sump tank, and when we turn on the pump again, the measurement will showing at the flow is coming of the about 39.3 LPMs from the sump tank by motor to the measuring tank. So this is the flow process control showing here by the visual representation. Now we will stop again. The flow is stop zero right now and valve is getting output, and we can also stop the process. So this will give the buzzer about 15 seconds and that will be automatically closed. This will show the process has been stopped and all the valves are closed. So this is the process of flow control system, that we have used the turbine flow sensor. Now we will do the same experiment with the flow level flow transmitter or the electromagnetic flow sensor. Now for the B part of this experiment, to measurement of the flow by electromagnetic flow sensor, the sensor 2, we will use the flow meter or flow transmitter sensor, and just we have to do the one thing, that we just have to close the valve 1 and open the valve 3. So the maximum flow of the water will be happen from with the flow electromagnetic flow sensor, and the readings can be done, and this will be output and this will be showing on the HMI as well. So now the output will be shown from the sensor 2. So we will start the process again. So right now that I have used the HMI in the last experiment, in the A part of this experiment, you can also do the experiments from the physical inputs also. So I will press start here. You can see the start indication or the process status is green right now on the HMI as well. This is on at both the processes. Now we will press pump and the pump will start. And this will start showing the flow, the liter per minute measured by the electromagnetic flow sensor. These are also almost same as the pump has given the fixed output of the 40 liters per minute, around 40 liters per minute. So this is how we measure the flow by electromagnetic flow sensor. So you can also see the graphical representation of the flow, that per second flow is showing with this graphical representation in this. So here you can see as I started the pump about 150 seconds, and 1150 seconds, and that after that the flow will gradually increase up to 40 liters per minute, and this is constant right now. Now I will stop the pump by pressing the valve here, and this will show the flow will decrease in the graph in per second, and this will be zero in some time. So this is the graphical representation also of the flow process given in the HMI. Also you can log all the data of flow measurement. These are present here, that you can press the log button, and by this log icon you can see in the last time and flow sensors of the per second is given. So you can also update and take out the file of this data logging in the USB by pressing this and connecting a USB beside the HMI panel, and you can select as required output and all the logs from fixed time to date and time, from which rate you want to log till which date and time the data you want. So this is the flow control system and flow process measurement system from the DAQ and HMI panel in the both the sensor types. Now we will also do the same experiment and calculations for actual rotameter also. So now for this we will close the valve 3 as well and open the valve 2. So this will show the flow from the rotameter. So now I will start the pump, and this is showing flow accordingly at the rotameter value. You can observe the flow is about 25 liters per minute, that is showing from the meter. So you can also decrease and increase the flow by closing or opening the valve V2A, which is the direct inlet to the sump tank, and this will vary the flow value in the different modes. So this is how the flow process control system works with the DAQ and HMI mode. Now we will do the experiment for the PID controller for process control. Now for experiment 2, the aim of this experiment to study the measurement of water flow using electromagnetic flow sensor, PID and flow current meter. So by this experiment we can measure the flow with the PID controller provided at the digital control meter panel, and the input of and the output of the electromagnetic sensor will be provided as an input to the PID controller first, then same input will be provided to the current meter. We will check the one by one outputs from both the control digital control meter panels. So these are the wiring description are given. So DAQ wiring will remain same for the controlling, so that we have not changing as per the last experiment. We have to do all the wiring from digital inputs and digital outputs for the DAQ panel. Now just we have to change the sensor PID controller connections. In this, the sensor panel electromagnetic sensor terminal T7 and T8 positive negative will be connected with the T5 and T6. This is a digital control panel meter, and after that we will remove the sensor output connection from PID controller, then we will be connect the output to the current meter to measuring the flow current. The flow sensor flow current meter only measure the currents for this purpose. So we will do the connections as per the user manual. For this we will connect the T7 positive of the electromagnetic sensor. This is the T7 positive of electromagnetic flow sensor. This will be connected with the T5 and T8 will be connected with the T6. So this is the output. Now as I connect the current loop to the PID controller, this will start showing some value. Now we will check the settings of the PID controller as requirement. So PID controller should be set at AIA2 symbol, which is showing the input is 4 to 20 milliampere of the current range. Now we will set the PID controller in the parameter 3. So this is the input type AIA2, which is already set, and this is the low limit of the current that is showing, which is the 4 milliamps, and this is the high limit of the current, which is the 20 milliamp, and dot should be 0.0 resolution. Low scaling is 0% and high scaling is 100%. In the percentage value, we can see the flow. So this is the all settings for the PID controller. After pressing the mode for about 2 seconds, we can go up to home settings, and this is the setting point here to set the flow. So as we require the flow, you can use the digital output. So digital output are not required in this experiment. So we will set the set values to 0 and press mode. Now I will start the pump. This will show generated current from the electromagnetic flow sensor will be provided as the loop, 4 to 20 current loop, and this loop will calculate and provide the output in the percentage of the flow. So now I will start the process by pressing start. The status bit also on. Now we will start the pump. So pump has been started, and we have to first open the valve 3 for the electromagnetic sensor, and rest of the valve positions will be remain same. So we require the flow meter only. So this is the value. Now you can calculate the flow is about 26.4 percentage. This is the percentage flow right now. To calculate the liter flow, you can do the calculations as required in the user manual. You can see the output of flow transmitter is 4 to 20 milliamps. Minimum value is 4 milliamps and maximum value is at 20 milliamps. So the span is 16. And PID controller flow range is 0 to 100% for 4 to 20 milliamps, and maximum minimum maximum value has. So the span will be step size is PID and step size in the PID controller. So therefore 1 milliampere PID input will be give the 6.25% of the flow. So rest of the calculations in the liter per minute, you can calculate the HMI display range is 3.82 in the minimum and 152.8 in the liter per minute. So the minimum maximum value is approx 149. So step size by you can calculate, therefore 1 milliamps of the HMI input will give the 9.31 liters per minute. So therefore the span ratio can be read up to 149 upon 100. 1.49 million. So actual flow water reading will be calculated by this factor, and this percentage will give you the accurate liters per minute. Right now the calculation has been done according 21%. So if the 21% flow is flowing with the PID controller, you can calculate the 21%, 21 minus 0 into 1.49, you will get the 31.29 liters per minute. So right now the flow is showing 26.7 percent here. So when we do the calculations as per the formula divided in the actual flow reading for the liter per minute, we will get approx 40 or 39 point something liters per minute accordingly. So that was we have measured from the rotameter and also from the flow sensor in the DAQ panel also. So this is how we use the PID controller. Now we will stop the process. First we will on the valve, so the outlet of the measuring tank will be going to the sump tank, and we will stop the process here. Now we will remove these connections from the PID controller, and then we provide this input to the current meter. So this will also show the current value. So we will provide the same inputs from T11 and T12. You can do the connections proper by reading the proper connections, and this input will be provided to the current meter. Now current meter setting has been done accordingly, 4 to 20 milliamps from 0 to 100. You can see the settings. So input is 4 milliamps, and moving on, resolution is 0.011, and display scale low is 0. That the at the low current, the 4 milliampere current, this will be showing the 0 value. Input scale low is already set as the 4 milliamps, and display scale high is set to 99.9. This is the 100% flow in the percentage, and input scale high is showing 20. This is the 20 milliamps, which is the highest limit from the output. And now all the settings has been done. Press the square key for 2 seconds. You will go back to the home screen. Now we will start the process again and start the pump. So this will again show the percentage reading of the flow that was showing in the PID controller. So the maximum flow from the flow meter is showing that the 24, 25 and 26 is the last hour measurement from the PID controller. So this is the same percentage value from the current meter also. You can calculate the same value as described in the calculations. So you can calculate the actual flow meter. So actual flow will be you get after calculating from 26.6 as the percentage. So this will be giving you the 39 liters per minute output of the pump. So you can now press the wall button. So the output from the wall will be happen. Now we will also see the current value changes in the flow while closing the and changing the flow rate of the actual flow from the electromagnetic flow sensor by opening the valve V2A. So now I will slowly open the valve V2A till 25%. So as I open the valve V2A 25%, now you can see the readings measured by the flow meter right now are decreased. You can see the flow is right now 19 and all continuously decreasing. It will stable for some time. Now you can see the flow is stabilizing. So right now the flow is divided to two parts. That's why the flow reading from the electromagnetic flow sensor is decreased. Now I will close the valve, open the valve some more. So we will open the valve about 80 or 75%. So the flow will be going and decrease again. So the flow is right now more decreasing. Here you can see this is now 6 liter, 5 liters per minute from the electromagnetic sensor. Now we will completely close the valve. Sorry, you completely open the V2A valve. So this is the 100% opening of this valve, and flow will be the minimum right now from the flow meter. So this will showing approx zero values right now. So this is the minimum value of the flow. Now we will completely close the valve again from increasing the flow. So now I will completely close the valve. So the flow will, maximum flow will be going to the electromagnetic flow sensor. So this is how we do the flow process control system. Now we will press the valve button. So the measurement tank will be empty through the sump tank, through the solenoid valves and the V5 valve. This is the manual valve to empty the tank and the bypass valve also. So this is how we do the experiment of flow process control system. And I have also described you the all the graphical and the visual representation of flow processing in different methods. So this is all about this practical. So this is of the video of flow process control system. In this we are using water as a medium to controlling the flow that we have working with the electromagnetic sensor and also the turbine flow sensor. The study about the turbine flow sensor and electromagnetic sensor are also described in the user manual also. So you can study the deep study of the both the sensor, how the sensor works and how the flow is controlled and how the flow is measured by these sensors. Also you can do the DAQ and HMI study also with this panel. So this is all about the process controlling of through the DAQ and the PID controller also. So while doing the experiments, if you find more difficulties and other problems and other concerns, you can contact Tuteska Technologies Private Limited for any type of support. Thank you.